Wow, is this not going to be the greatest day? I am so excited about our message today, and we're going to talk about emotions and how emotions need medicine, especially when you have crazy emotions, right? I don't know what you're going through in your life, but if you're crying all day, or you're complaining all day, or you're upset all day, or you're having to struggle all day, then today's the day that quits. We're going to learn how to have emotions the way God planned us to have them. Emotions are real, and they're for you, and God gave them to you to give you compassion in your life, but He didn't give you emotions to control you, and they're neither positive or negative. Emotions are neither positive or negative. Emotions are what they are. They are feelings. And if your feelings don't line up with the Word of God that says you're His holy beloved child today, and you can have everything He says you can have, then you're on the wrong path with your emotions. I love you so much. We're going to talk about how to medicate our emotions today, and we're not going to do it with the medicine of the world. I love you. I'm Rose. This is Clearer Vision, and we're going to get together and see how clear we can make everything. In the name of Jesus. See you in just a minute.
God chose to richly bless you and make you His greatest blessing. Order Living God's Rich Life in Excellence today. This timely teaching by Rose guides you through 8 powerful principles that will keep you living rich in God's excellent victory every day. Are you ready to live in divine health with all your needs and desires met and blessed beyond your dreams? Order today and begin living God's rich life. And remember to request your 30-day devotional, 30 Days, The Champion in You.
Praise the Lord, we are having the best time here in the studio today. We're talking about all kind of good things to do with our message and each other. And I want us to learn today about emotions. I'm studying and I'm reading to you and teaching you from this wonderful little book I've done called Living God's Rich Life in Excellence. And I want you to call the ministry or write in or however you want to and order this book. I want to make it as a gift to you for whatever donation amount you want to provide. But you call in and you get this little book because in it are 8 principles that will lead you and keep you in the victory of God in your life. You are an overcomer. You are a blessed, holy child of God. And God wants you to stay that way. And there are 8 principles if you'll follow every time you get off track a little bit. If you'll go back and see which one of these you stepped out of, then you're going to find out what it is and correct it. Today we're talking about one of the principles in this little book, and it's called principle number 3, your emotions need medicine oftentimes. I don't know who's watching, but you may be on medications for your nerves. You may be on medications for many things, but God says His Word is medicine, and it heals. And He says His Word is like water, and it washes, and it cleanses. God is the greatest medicine there is. You see, beloved, it's fine to have emotions. It's fine to have emotions that are neither positive or negative. Because emotions are not that. Emotions follow how you think. If you're thinking about going and having a great time today, then emotionally you're very happy. You're joyful. And your little body's just rejoicing with all that good chemicals that are flowing in your mind and in your body because you're going to go have a good time. If you're not having a good time, if you're facing a difficult situation, and then you're thinking about it, and you're tormenting over it, and you're frustrated, and you're aggravated, then that's when your emotions set in. And then you start getting depressed, and you start thinking that life isn't worth living. And life is worth living. Life is what God gave you, a life of goodness. And that's what He wants you to have. God sent His Word to heal you and snatch you out of destruction. If you're in a despairing situation today, God has His Word ready to snatch you out of that destruction. He doesn't just have faith and healing. God is faith and healing. If you'll change your sad, mad thinking attitudes, let's say that again. If you'll change your sad, mad thinking attitude, and you will take on God's sweet loving Word, then you will start going from sad, mad emotions, okay, because that's what follows when you're sad and mad thinking, and your attitude's sad and mad. Then you'll go from sad, mad emotions into glad attitude mind. God wants you to be glad attitude minded. See, abusive talk and actions at that point will become unthinkable. Many times we make decisions and we make them based on our emotions. I teach people, don't make an irreversible decision ever in a downtime. Don't ever come out of a place of despair and try to make a decision or have an attitude from your emotions that are negative or that are just discouraging you to the point that you don't even think you have the will to go on. When you seek God, He will see to it. He will see to it that your emotions will be healed. See, the Word heals. And God wants you to look in His Word for that healing. Let's look real quick at 2 Kings 20, 4 and 5. And 2 Kings 20, 4 and 5 is a great place to find out that you can expect God's healing. 2 Kings 20, let's get over there to it real quick. It's talking about Hezekiah. And Hezekiah had prayed to the Lord and asked the Lord to give him more time, because the Lord told him it was his time to leave the earth. And the Lord said to Hezekiah, before Isaiah had gone out of the middle of the court, the word of the Lord came to him. And the word of the Lord said, turn back and tell Hezekiah, the leader of my people, thus says the Lord, the God of David, your forefather, I have heard your prayer. I have seen your tears. Behold, I will heal you. I heard your prayers. I have seen your tears. Behold, I will heal you. God wants you healed. And God's healing comes through His Word. Because this word is medicine. God says it's medicine, and it heals you. And it's water. It's like water, and it cleanses and washes you. Let's look at Psalms 12:6 real quick. Psalms 12:6 tells us that God's Word is pure. And when you have an emotional situation going on in your life, and you're just torn up in your heart and your thinking and your feelings are running rampant and dictating every way you're thinking, let's look at Psalms 12:6 and see what to do about that. It says, the words and promises of the Lord are pure words, like silver refined in an earthen furnace, purified seven times over. If you will keep them and preserve them, you will guard and keep the evil from your life. God wants you to understand, honey, that His Word will keep you. His Word will cleanse you. His Word will wash you like water. Let's look at John 15:3. I don't tell you anything that I haven't studied out in the Word. If somebody's telling you something and they can't back it up in the Word, then you go to the Word and find out what the Word has to say about it. And that's what you stand on. You don't stand on what somebody says if they can't show you where it is in the Word. And you don't stand on what anybody thinks or how you feel if it disagrees with the Word of God. So let's look at John 15:3 that says, and this is Jesus talking, and He was telling the people that He is the vine. See, now right before that, He'd been talking about being the way, the truth, and the life, and that Satan had come and was going to come and destroy, kill, and steal. And then he goes on and he says, I am the vine, the true vine, and my Father is the vine dresser. And any branch in me that does not bear fruit, that stops bearing, is repeatedly pruned, and every branch that continues to bear fruit makes it bear more and richer and more excellent fruit. Now here we get to the part about the cleansing like the water. You are cleansed and pruned already because of the word which I have given you. The teachings I have discussed with you. Dwell in me and I will dwell in you. Live in me and I will live in you. Just as no branch can bear fruit of itself without abiding in being vitally united to the vine, neither can you bear fruit unless you abide in me. See, God wants you to be fruitful. He wants your life to be blessed with millions and millions of things that are going on for you, things that He's planned. And God wants His water to wash you and sanctify you and bring you into that place that you're cleansed and pure. And He says His Word does that. I know that you want God's royal love and Word in your life. I know that you want to be cleansed like water. I know that you want to make yourself and see yourself holy. I know that because that's how God created you. And with that, He put a desire in your heart and an emotional attitude in your life to desire that, to want that. And God says He will always, always give you the opportunity to think about faith and to be cleansed with His Word. He will always give you that opportunity. So what I want you to do today, I want you to give your mind and your mouth a big old bath. I want you to get into these scriptures that I'm speaking to you about. I want you to stop flying hopelessly around in fear and anger and lonely emotional living. You may be watching the program and you just feel like you are all alone and there's nobody can help you and there's nothing anybody can do that's going to make life better for you. Beloved, that's not what God says. God says that He has love and forgiveness for you. He has love that He wants you to have and forgiveness that He's provided for you, and He wants you to become love and forgiveness minded. Become love and forgiveness minded. Become victory minded. Keep your mind set on the Lord. Forgiveness is a big key in powerful, peaceful living. Forgiveness helps you move on. Forgiveness helps you get out of your emotions of fear and doubt and unbelief. Forgiveness puts you in that place that you can unchain yourself from the past. Forgiveness keeps you from living in emotions that make you unforgiving. Somebody may have hurt you. Maybe long ago. Maybe they've hurt you recently. And you are very upset about it, and you're very distraught about it, and you don't know how to get past it. Well, it's a decision. It's a decision to study and read and speak the Word of God out loud and let that Word cleanse you. Cleanse your heart. Cleanse your mind. Medicate you. I've had occasions in my life, I've had circumstances in my life where I thought, if I have to live one more day, I don't think I can do it under these circumstances. And God would come to me and He'd say, Rose, I love you. I want you to know that. And I love you with all my heart. And I have a plan for your life. And today is a new day, and tomorrow will be another new day. So let's get into tomorrow and see what happens. Let's decide tomorrow what we're going to do tomorrow. Let's don't make decisions today to live in our emotions. Let's get the medicine of my word. That's how God talks to me. I'll be right back. I love you so much. I am so excited about what this message is doing in your heart today. And I know it's helping you. I want to hear from you because of it. I'll see you in just a minute. We'll talk more about how we can wash our minds and our mouth and give ourselves a big old bath in the Word of God. I love you so much. Talk to you in just a minute. I'm Rose.
God chose to richly bless you and make you His greatest blessing. Order Living God's Rich Life in Excellence today. This timely teaching by Rose guides you through 8 powerful principles that will keep you living rich in God's excellent victory every day. Are you ready to live in divine health with all your needs and desires met and blessed beyond your dreams? Order today and begin living God's rich life. And remember to request your 30-day devotional, 30 Days, The Champion in You.
Every day I get to come and praise the Lord, and today I'm praising the Lord with you. Today I am giving you medicine for your emotions, and that's what we're talking about, how to medicate your emotions and get yourself out of this attitude of whining and complaining and having a hard time with everything that's going on around you. See, God every day expects you. He expects you to get up expecting Him to give you His healing love and joy, and to give that to yourself. He expects you to get up and give that to those around you all over the earth at least 10 times a day. 10 times a day, that's once an hour while you're awake, unless you stay up all night. At least 10 times a day, declare and affirm, I expect the best, and with God's help, I will attain the best. Because that's what God wants for you. I expect the best, and with God's help, I will attain the best. God wants His best for you. I want you to declare, to keep standing strong, live long, fight the good fight of faith. That's the only fight we have, is the fight of faith. That means that we stand in the Word that says we can be strong in the faith of God, the faith of God in you, not your faith, but the faith of God in you. Strike hard at threats against your life, against your mind, against your heart, against your body. Strike harder. Let's talk about this a minute. What example do we have to go by? Well, I got so excited when I turned over to the Scripture here in Mark 14, because I've read this so many times, and yet every time I read it, I get a new blessing. I get a new revelation of this Word. And I read it this morning early and through the night when I was preparing to come here with you, and I'm reading it now. And let's just look at what Jesus did here in Mark 14. See, God gives us Jesus as our example to follow. He gave us His Son to know how to stand and be emotionally stable and to fight off with the Word of God every attack against us. It says, and He took with Him Peter and James and John and began to be struck with terror and amazement and deeply troubled and depressed. I don't believe I've ever heard too many messages talking about Jesus being troubled or depressed or distressed. But He was right here in Mark 14. And where were they? They were at the garden. And He took with Him Peter and James and John and began to be struck with terror and amazement and deeply troubled and depressed. And He said to them, my soul is exceedingly sad, overwhelmed with grief, so that it almost kills me. Remain here and keep awake and be watching. Jesus had gone into the Garden of Gethsemane, beloved. He was preparing to die, preparing to be crucified, preparing to face the awfulness of the beatings that would come on Him because of our sins. He was preparing to die and to rise again. He was preparing in his heart and mind. He was preparing as a man. And he was preparing as the Lord. And it says, And I'm going to read this again. And he said to them, "My soul is exceedingly sad, overwhelmed with grief, so that it almost kills me. Remain here and keep awake and be watching." And going a little further, Jesus fell on the ground and kept praying that if it were possible, the fatal hour might pass from him. Have you experienced such a trouble in your life that you fall to the ground and you beg God, if it be possible, if it be possible, let this hour pass from me? I have. I don't know anybody that hasn't, because we all have lived in those times of struggle and despair. But Jesus made the decision not to follow his emotions. He made the decision, he made the choice to do what the Father had asked him to do. And he goes right on here and says, "Abba, Abba Father, everything is possible for you. Take this cup from me, yet not what I will, but what you will." And he accepted what God had for him. Jesus knew that he was dying for you. He knew that he was dying for me. He knew that he was going to take the sin of every human being for all eternity on his back, on his life, in his heart, and that it would mar him beyond recognition. Jesus knew what that would do for you. He knew that his Father's word would be for you. He knew that his word that says you're healed and made whole would come to pass when that happened. Jesus knew, regardless of how he felt, he had to do what the Father had asked him to do. You and I only have to agree with God's goodness. God doesn't ask us to suffer anymore. He doesn't ask us to torment. He doesn't ask us to be in strife and out of our minds. He doesn't ask us to do that. He doesn't ask us to struggle. God asks you to bless you, to let him bless you. He asks you to overcome your emotions of hurt and anger and unforgiveness. He asks you to overcome those and agree that he's going to bless you. I want to read you a letter that I got, a most powerful letter that came in the mail last week. And we wanted to minister to the military, the U.S. Army, the Air Force, the Navy. We wanted to minister to everyone in the military. So we contacted the Department of Army in Washington, D.C. at the Walter Reed Medical Army Medical Center. And we sent them our little books, Living God's Rich Life in Excellence, 30 Days, The Champion in You, other books that we have, ministering books, books of encouragement. And we sent those books to them and we told them, we want to make these materials available to the soldiers coming home, to their families that are hurting. We want to make these little books of God's Word of encouragement at all times possible for them to have, to just quickly read and know God's Word. And we sent those little books knowing that they would evaluate them, they'd read them, and they would decide if they thought they were valuable and would want them. And last week I got this letter. "Dear friends of Mercy House and Rose Ministries, thank you for your thoughtful contribution to our soldiers at Walter Reed Army Medical Center, Washington, D.C. The devotionals titled 30 Days, The Champion in You, Love is on the Throne, and God's Royal Confidence, and others, are gifts that will cheer our soldiers and their families. As our nation is at war and soldiers are deployed across the globe, your contribution to the health and welfare of those who serve our nation is a special gift indeed. As chaplains who serve a special group of Americans, it's our privilege to pass on your act of kindness to our wounded warriors and their families. I cannot adequately express how grateful our troops are as they undergo such difficult times in their lives. It has a positive impact and accelerates their healing, knowing someone cares. And your little books indicate that. We see tragedy every day, but there are blessings in such caring, generosity, and compassionate acts of service that you display. I pray that you will remember soldiers' appreciation of your service that went above and beyond the call of duty and will not be soon forgotten. You at Mercy House, you at Rose Ministries, exemplify the best that America has to offer. God bless you. Sincerely, Major Chaplain, United States Army, Senior Chaplain Christy Pappas. Beloved, when you support this ministry, when you sow into the kingdom in this ministry, you are sowing seeds of medicine, seeds of water that cleanse. You are sowing the Word of God. You are saving the life of people who have offered their life on your behalf in Iraq, Iran, all over this earth. We are available to the soldiers and their families. We made this ministry available some months back because of the reports of suicides in our military increasing. And now we have a letter from the Walter Reed Army Medical Center praising the Lord for the Word of God coming from this ministry. I want you to pray about your support here. I want you to pray about your giving. If you feel the Lord lead you, as you feel the Lord lead you, whether He wants you to give hundreds of dollars or thousands of dollars, you decide. You decide to emotionally stand for those who have stood for you. Stand for the Lord. Stand for the soldiers and the families that have made life possible for us on this earth. In the name of Jesus, I love you. Order your books. Call me for prayer. And until I see you next time, I'm Rose, and this is Ben Clear Vision. I love you so much. See you next time. And call in and get your books. I'm waiting to hear from you. God love you. I love you so much. See you next time.